Senator Brown and Wyden ask the following question for the House managers. During yesterday's proceedings, the President's counsel failed to give an adequate response to a question related to whether acceptance of information provided by a foreign country to a political campaign or candidate would constitute a violation of the law, and whether offers of such information should be reported to the FBI. FBI Director Christopher Wray, who was appointed by President Trump, has said, quote, "If any public official or member of any campaign is contacted by any nation state or anybody acting on behalf of a nation state about influencing or interfering with our election, then that is something that the FBI would want to know about," end quote. "And we'd like to make sure people tell us information promptly so that we can take the appropriate steps to protect the American people," end quote. If President Trump remains in office, what signal does that send to other countries intent on interfering with our elections in the future, and what might we expect from those countries and the President?
Mr. Chief Justice, distinguished members of the Senate, thank you for that question. To take the last part first, it would send a terrible message to autocrats and dictators and enemies of democracy and the free world for the President and his team to essentially put out there for all to consume that it's acceptable in the United States to solicit foreign interference in our free and fair elections or accept political dirt simply to try to cheat in the next election. I was certainly shocked by the comments from the President's Deputy White House Counsel yesterday right here on the floor when he said, "I think the idea that any information that happens to come from overseas is necessarily campaign interference is a mistake." No, it's wrong. It's wrong in the United States of America. He also added information that is credible, that potentially shows wrongdoing by someone that happens to be running for office, if it's credible information, is relevant for the voters to know to be able to decide on who is the best candidate. This is not a banana republic. It's the Democratic Republic of the United States of America. It's wrong. Now, the single most important lesson that we learned from 2016 was that nobody should seek or welcome foreign interference in our elections. But now we have this President and his counsel essentially saying it's okay. It is not okay. It strikes at the very heart of what the framers of the Constitution were concerned about: abuse of power, betrayal by the President of his oath of office, corrupting the integrity of our democracy and our free and fair elections by entangling oneself with foreign powers. That's at the heart of what the framers of the Constitution were concerned about. Don't just trust me. We have several folks who have made this observation. The FBI director, the Trump FBI director, said that the FBI would want to know about any attempt at foreign election interference. And the chair of the Federal Elections Commission also issued a statement reiterating the view of U.S. law enforcement. She said in part, "Let me make something 100% clear to the American people and anyone running for office. It is illegal for any person to solicit, accept, or receive anything of value from a foreign national in connection with a U.S. election. This is not a novel concept. Election intervention from foreign governments has been considered unacceptable since the beginning of our nation. It is wrong, it is corrupt, it is lawless, it's an abuse of power, It's impeachable, and it should lead to the removal of President Donald John Trump.
Thank you, Mr. Manager.